I had a young woman who had graduated a incredibly good school, Colorado College, here down south, where my daughter goes, actually, who had gone through some really traumatic events, who was totally addicted to benzos, completely minimizing, even telling us the truth, how much they were actually taking. Well, benzos themselves give you the sense of well-being that you don't have any anxiety, that you basically, it takes the feeling of worry and panic and all of that, and it just lowers it down. It literally lowers our heart rate, puts us in a position where we feel okay. Well, if you've been feeling chronic anxiety, why wouldn't you want to take benzos? Because anxiety is horrible. Any of us who have been up all night, worried about something, you know, like all of us have experienced some anxiety, and some of us have experienced really bad anxiety in moments. But if you look at having that anxiety 24 hours a day, it makes it really difficult. So, you know, in this case, well-meaning doctors prescribed them medication in order to be able to help deal with those. And this person became addicted. You know, they have a substance use disorder. Not everybody gets hooked.
They couldn't stop. They didn't want to be taking it.
They didn't want to be taking it. They couldn't stop. And when they did stop, they had things like seizures and got really, really sick, but were afraid to tell people what they're really on because they're afraid that their parents are going to judge them, afraid of others. So everybody knows there's something wrong. There's hospital stays that happen. There's different things that happen, but there's still this kind of minimization that's going on. So when I met with this person, I basically said to them, like, look, you know, I see what's going on. I see it. I've been there to a degree myself. And the real question is, like, are you ready for something different? Are you really ready? And I'm not gonna hide from you and tell you, like, it's going to be painful. Like, it's not like we just stop and it's okay. It's like, that's going to be really challenging. But it sounds like what you're doing right now is really challenging too, which is like trying to live as an addicted person and get things done. And that's not working out. So this is going to be difficult in a different kind of way. This was an up and down path. This person started an IOP that didn't work out initially because they were still using and needed to do some other things. Long story short, they ended up we ended up detoxing this person at the hospital. They went away to treatment for a period of time, came back into our IOP, and have done really, really, really well. And they're off benzos entirely and just came to me and brought me a mate. You can probably tell I like mate. Brought me a mate for a meeting we had the other day, celebrating a year of being completely sober, which was a really cool feeling.
And, okay, that's a great story.
But that was a hopeless case. That was one that everyone was like, no.
Why would they think it's hopeless?
Just because person had a ton of money, ton of resources, not a bunch of motivation to change, had their own money, was in a situation where there's like no leverage to hold over this person, wasn't married, there was nothing you could really take away from this person, and they had a willingness to do something different. And I think what we successfully did there is we helped really quiet the shame. We really helped douse the flames of the shame just to create enough space that you could begin to look at this honestly in a way that's not feeling like good person, bad person.
That's